Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part three of doing a word problem about angles in a triangle, and we're going to do this word problem here. So read the problem yourself, and then put the video on pause and try it on your own. Try defining your variables and writing an equation, solving it, and checking it. All right, so let's go ahead and try this. In a triangle, one angle is 4 degrees more than the measure of the smallest angle, and the measure of the third angle is twice the measure of the smallest angle. Find the measures of the angles. We don't know the measures of any of the angle, but we know there are three angles. So we're just going to start by writing, first, second, and third. We want to define them somehow. And basically, we've got a smallest angle. So how about I call the first one instead of the first angle, I'll call it just the smallest one. Because the other two are defined in terms of the smallest one. So how about we start with X? If that's the smallest one, then one angle is 4 degrees more than the measure of the smallest. Okay. So if the smallest is x and it's 4 degrees more, this would be what? X plus 4. Now it's really x plus 4 degrees. I'm going to go ahead and leave off the degree symbol, but at the end of the problem, when we write our answer, we have to remember to write it in degrees. And what else do we know? The measure of the third angle is twice the measure of the smallest angle. Okay, so the third angle would be what? The smallest angle is 3, and it's twice that measure. That would have to be 2x. Now we have to use our knowledge about the angles in a triangle. We know that the sum of the three angles in a triangle, their measures add up to 180 degrees. So that's the next step is to write our equation. So we've got the first angle is x plus the next angle is x plus 4, and the third angle is 2x. We know that adds up to 180 degrees. I'm leaving off the degree symbol on everything, and at the end we'll have to remember to put in the degrees. Okay, so now we have an equation, and we can solve that on the left side by adding the like terms. So we have x plus 2x. Those are the like terms on the left side, so we have 4x plus 4 equals 180. And then from here, we could subtract 4 from both sides. And that gives me 4x is 176. And then we would have to divide both sides by 4. And 4 goes into 176 44 times. So we got that x is 44. All right, now what did x stand for? Well, x stood for the smallest angle. So this was 44, right? This is 4 degrees more. I'm going to put plus degrees now. So that'll be, what's that? 44 plus 4 would be 48 degrees. And the third angle is 2x. And remember, x is 44. So 2 times 44 is 88 degrees. All right, so before we're sure that's the answer, let's first make sure those three angles add up to 180 degrees. So let's check that the three angles add up. So we've got 44 degrees, 48 degrees, and 8 degrees. And if we add those up, let's see, we've got 16, 20, carry the 2, and that does give me 180 degrees. So that part checks. We're not quite done checking though. You've got to look back at the words. That's the important part. Says in a triangle, one angle is 4 degrees more than the measure of the smallest angle. Okay, so you look at your angles here. Is it true that one angle is 4 degrees more than the smallest? Well, yeah, that 48 degrees is 4 more than the smallest. Is it also true that the third angle is twice as big as the smallest angle? And you look at it, 88, yeah, that's twice as big. So you want to go back up to the words and make sure your answer makes sense. So our answer is the angles measure 44 degrees, 48 degrees, and 88 degrees. We've done another word problem dealing with triangles and angles. All right, that's the end of the problem, but I want to go back to something here. Our equation that we got when we had 4x plus 4 equals 80, just show you another way to solve that equation. We had 4x plus 4 equals 180. I think I said 80 in the last thing. Now, the way we did it was subtract 4 and then divide by 4. But I noticed that all the terms on both sides have a factor of 4. If you want, you could divide everything by 4 first, and you get an easier equation. So this just becomes x plus 1, and then 180 divided by 4. Well, you could divide by 2 and get 90, and then divide by 2 again. That's 45. And then this is simple. You just subtract 1 from both. It's another way to get that x is 44. So that has nothing to do with a word problem. Just, you know, sometimes you look at an equation and there's more than one way to solve it. I'm just using the fact that you could divide both sides of the equation by the same number. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.